Hello children, welcome back to my class. Today I am going to explain the fourth question of this construction chapter. Let me read the question. Construct an isosceles triangle whose base is 8 cm and altitude is 4 cm and another triangle whose sides are 1/2 times of the corresponding side of an isosceles triangle. For this question you should understand, what is isosceles triangle? What do you mean by isosceles triangle? If any in a triangle, if any two sides are equal, if these two sides are equal, then it is known as isosceles triangle. Here for an isosceles triangle, this will be the base, correct? What do you mean by altitude? Altitude is nothing but the perpendicular line, that is height. Height of the isosceles triangle is 4 cm according to the given question. Is it clear, children? So now I am going to construct an isosceles triangle x, y and z. Isosceles triangle with side xy is equal to yz. But we don't know the side measurement. We know only the base and the altitude. Altitude is nothing but the perpendicular line, that is the height of the isosceles triangle. So for this, draw a straight line. Draw a straight line 8 cm. Draw a straight line. Now mark it as y and z. Is it clear? Now I should measure one altitude that is perpendicular to this yz. So how to measure this perpendicular line? Take more than half of this line segment. Take more than half. See here, more than half. So take more than half of this line segment, mark an arc. Same way, keep your compass needle in Z and cut the arc. So these two lines will intersect here. Now draw a perpendicular line. Draw a straight line. Is it clear? Now this is the altitude. But altitude, how much measurement it is given? 4 cm, correct? So in your compass, measure 4 cm. See, exact 4 cm in your compass. Measure exact 4 cm. Keep your compass needle in the base of this perpendicular line. Then mark an arc. Is it clear? Did you understand? Actually, this is the exact measurement, that altitude is 4 cm. Is it clear? Now join. Now this is x. Join xy and xz. Now you have drawn an isosceles triangle. Isosceles triangle means, in a triangle, any two sides are equal in measurement, then it is known as isosceles triangle. According to this question, xy and xz are equal in measurement. If you measure with the scale, both the sides will have same measurement. Is it clear, children? Now, second part. What is the second triangle? It should be 1/3. So, 1/2. It is a mixed fraction. Is it? So mixed fraction should convert into improper fraction. How to convert? Multiply this 2, 2 and 1. 2 ones are 2. With this answer, add this one. 2 plus 1, 3. So the final answer will be 3/2 in the improper fraction. So 1/2, if you convert into improper fraction, you will get 3/2. So 3/2, whether the second triangle will be bigger or smaller? Yeah, because the numerator is bigger, so the second triangle will be bigger. Bigger means it will come outside the first triangle. Is it clear? Now draw a ray of suitable measurement. Let it be A. Now I should equally divide this line segment. How many equal parts? Because here, which is the bigger number? 3. So, 3 equal parts I should divide. Let me take little bit bigger so that you can easily visible. 2, and 3. Is it clear, children? Now what I should do? I should give the name. Here y means you should give y1, y2 and y3. Where I should keep the point? Because the ratio is 3/2. So in 3 I should mark one point and 2 I should mark another point. Is it clear? Now the triangle, second triangle is bigger. That means it will come outside. So in the point I should join. Join this y2 and z. Now take your compass. With a suitable measurement in your compass, draw an arc. Is it clear? Now same measurement, keep it in y3, draw an arc. Now adjust your compass so that the measurement should be exact this measurement. Able to see? Yeah. Same measurement, keep your compass needle here, cut this arc. Again, if it is not intersecting, what we should do? Extend this arc. Is it clear? Now, this is the exact point, you should draw the line. So, draw a straight line passing through this intersecting arc. By seeing itself, see, these two lines are parallel. Parallel means exact conception is correct. Now extend this z. This is z dash. Is it clear? So again, with a suitable measurement, draw an arc. Same measurement, draw another arc. Now adjust your pencil and compass so that exact measurement should mark it here. Is it clear? Now draw a straight line passing through this. Here most of the students will do one minor mistake. Because the altitude we will draw a little bit bigger, so they will come and join here. Actually, which is the side of the first triangle? XY is the side of the first triangle. You should extend XY. You should not join with the altitude. Is it clear, children? Now draw a straight line. Extend this side, XY. So that it will get intersect here. This is x dash. Is it clear, children? Now, as I said in the previous video, just measure this measurement x and y, x dash, y dash, write x dash, y dash and write down the value. Same way, measure y, z dash, write down the value and x dash, y dash, write down the value. Is it clear, children? I hope you have understand. If you like my video, please subscribe my channel so that you will get the updates.